During my research for my video about the TV-guided Henschel 293D glide bomb, I came across some papers on an American TV-guided bomb. Secret weapons from the Allies are often overshadowed by the German Wunderwaffen, but the US developed a line of very interesting smart bombs. One of those was the GB-4 glide bomb. I already explained how a TV-guiding system works in my HS293D video, so I won't go into technical details on this system. Links to my sources are as always provided in the description. The GB-4 was developed from the GB-1 glide bomb. The GB-1 was a 2,000-pound AN M66 bomb with a pair of wings strapped on the back. A gyroscope held it on a straight course during the glide. The GB-4 had a redesigned body and was given an RC system so it could be steered by the bombardier. A camera under the body allowed the bombardier to see what's in front of the bomb. Development of the GB-4, then named MX-108, started in the summer of 1942 at the US Army Air Force Wright Field Equipment Laboratory. The Radio Company of America, or in short RCA, developed a TV system at the same time. The TV equipment was refined until summer 1943, but RCA stayed with the old iconoscope imaging tubes instead of the more modern super iconoscopes. First GB-4s were tested under the name MX-618 in August 1943. The GB-4 with the final AN/AXT2 TV system was ordered into production in January 1944. The GB-4 was pressed into service by the US Army Air Force in summer 1944 to attack V-1 launch ramps. Wikipedia states that the 388th Bombardment Group flew the missions, but I couldn't verify this information. 1,200 GB-4s were delivered to the US Army Air Force, but poor combat performance, unreliability of the radio equipment, and the dependency on bright sunshine for the camera tube halted further deliveries in February 1945. GB-9 and JB-4 were derivatives of the GB-4. The JB-4 was a jet bomb configuration of the GB-4 and had a Ford PJ-31 pulse jet on its back. The GB-9 was equipped with a radio altimeter. It would dive to build up speed and automatically pull out of this dive at a preset altitude. The GB-9 would then glide at high speed. It was intended to TV guide them into submarine pens. So you made it to the end of the video. I hope you liked this shorter video. If you want to know how the TV equipment of the HS293D worked, have a look at my video on the subject. And if you want to know more about the crazy missions of the 388th Operations Group, watch Mark Felton's video about Project Aphrodite.